Why during holiday planning season, during Q4, why is this important now to get a grip on your email, SMS, and CRM strategy? Why is this important to focus on right now? Well, number one, you see that snow globe all the way down the bottom right here. You can see that it's you know, think of the world right now of e-commerce as a, like I said, a big snow globe where, you know, COVID-19 disrupted everything and disrupted all traditional buying patterns, and everything's kind of mixed up, and, you know, one-time buyers came here and a ton of buyers started buying in your store here. They came out of nowhere and everyone just went to Amazon too, you know, so COVID-19 disrupted everything. And if you are focusing on one channel and focusing on your customers, they may have jumped to another brand. They may have jumped to somewhere else just to get something more convenient or better pricing, whatever it may be. But right now, these pieces are all falling down. Like that snow globe, everything got shook up, pieces are still falling down. So you have the opportunity now to grab a better, you know, portion of your customer base. You have that opportunity to collect as much as you can. Take advantage of it. Otherwise, here's what happens. Amazon will come, absorb your customers through their dominant flywheel, and you have to compete, right? That's what it is. You have to compete with Amazon and how they approach it, right? The flywheel is pretty much that customers will start saying everything revolves on the customer, and you have, you know, you're acquiring a customer, you're growing their value, and then you're going to constantly send it back out to the marketplace and start, you know, getting more like them. Well, Amazon is doing the same exact thing. Amazon is saying, we're going to grab as many people as we can, you know, at low price, and capture them all. So you have to compete. You can't compete. When they're working on two-day shipping and you finally got two-day shipping on board, guess what? They're already jumping over into one-day shipping. When you're finally got one-day shipping going, they're already into two-hour delivery. So you know what I mean? You can't compete with it. Instead, you focus on the hearts and minds of the customer. That's why it's important now, because Amazon will keep coming. They're coming to brick and mortar. From what I heard, they're opening up in the local mall near you as a fulfillment center and also as a kind of a shopping experience. You need to jump on it right away. And finally, there's direct-to-consumer, not finally, but there's another one. Direct-to-consumer brands and apps are inserting themselves between you and the customer. Uber Eats, DoorDash, you name it, are coming in. And before, you had a great relationship with your customer and you could communicate with them, maybe not at scale, but you were definitely communicating with them. Now, your customer prefers communicating through Uber Eats. Oh, I could order from you by picking up the phone and calling, but you know, Uber Eats is so much more convenient. So I'm going to order from you from Uber Eats here and order from DoorDash instead of calling you. Well, that's a shame. You just lost that connection. So their apps are inserting themselves between you and the customer. You need to solve that before you lose them all. Paid media is also getting pricier and erodes your margins, right? Everyone is now in e-commerce. There is a huge boost in e-commerce spending. Paid media, of course, it's an auction. The more people that are bidding, the higher the prices will get. So it's getting pricier and will erode your margins. Focusing on email, SMS, and CRM is the one area where you can say, like, I can be more profitable, not spend a ton of money, and actually, you know, win the hearts and minds of a customer and make more money, grow more value. But the number one reason why this is important now is this: it costs 600 to 700% more to acquire a customer than to keep a customer, right? It's cheaper to retain than gain. So why pay Google, Facebook to picture this? Why pay Google and Facebook to get you leads to your store? And then you're paying Google and Facebook to get those leads back. At some point right here in this middle is where you have the opportunity to capture that person, market to them for free, and use those other channels as supplemental, right? As incremental. It's free, right? And it's much more expensive to try and acquire a customer by getting them here and then getting them back. Once they're in their store, this is exactly where you need to catch them. What's your name? What's your email? What's your phone number? Let's stay in touch. That's what it comes down to, right? If you went to a store, you would get the same approach. So why are you doing that? Why pay all this media when it's cheaper to retain a person than it is to gain a person? Especially going back to the Pareto principle. Remember, if you lost one of those 20% of your population, well, that would be hard to replicate, right? You can't replicate a $10,000 a year customer by trying to acquire a $100 a year customer. That's inefficient. That's going to be really bad for business. Existing customers trust more, they convert better, and they grow faster. So knowing that is so important, because that's why brands grow. That's how the top brands are growing, by leveraging their existing customers and getting them to buy more. How do you keep customers? email, SMS, and CRM. That's the strategy. That's how the top 1% of brands are thinking about their marketing, are thinking about everything they're doing. It's revolving around the customer, and they want to keep as many as they can.